kind of short this week. Not a whole ton going on, just a few news notes and nuggets from around the web. But let's tackle them in hobby happenings here. We'll talk with some crime news first. Sports Collectors Daily reports that a former city employee and college basketball coach in Indiana is accused of using $246,000 in city funds to buy sports card boxes, some of which he then sold online for profit. I like how they put the profit in, because when you steal something, it's all profit, right?
Oh, he didn't rip all the boxes open with himself, and you know.
Mark Green, 51, the former parks superintendent in Columbia City near Fort Wayne, is now facing charges of corrupt business influence, official misconduct, and 4 counts of theft. All of this under the banner of embezzlement. Court documents show that Green bought boxes of cards from a local hobby shop. Oh, and that shop just lost their whale. Holy cow. Using a city credit card, and indicate that the scheme lasted from 2018 until just very recently. Green turned himself into authorities and was released the same day under a $50,000 recognizance bond. He's expected in court next week.
A card error and a full-page apology ad in a newspaper. What year, what team, and what pack? Find out.
Let's talk about the only card error in history that required a full-page ad in the newspaper to apologize for it. Clark Griffith was the owner of the Washington Senators, and he wanted to move the team to Minnesota. Now, one of the most important things to Clark was that both St. Paul and Minneapolis supported the team, so he didn't want the team name to alienate either of those communities, so they settled on the Minnesota Twins. So imagine how mad Clark Griffith was when the 1961 post-serial cards came out, and it said Minneapolis at the top of the card. So according to Don Mabee, who's the expert on these 1960s post-serial cards, the error was caught before the cards went to press, but they had to be released, otherwise the entire set would have been delayed. So a second printing came out that listed the team name correctly, but that didn't keep Post from apologizing publicly. A full page ad was taken out in the Minneapolis Star Tribune with the headline, "Boy, did we goof."
Isn't that cool? Who would have thunk? Well, eBay is sponsoring a series of collectible trading events at local hobby shops this year, and held its first event at Baseball Card Connection in Illinois this past Saturday. Now, I couldn't find locate a full participating list, but Sports Collectors Daily notes that other stops include May 13th at Santiago Sports Cards in Mattawa, New Jersey, June 10th at Troll and Toad, a gaming store in Lexington, Kentucky, and as yet unannounced dates at Hoodies Collectibles in Beaverton, Oregon, and Bullpen, LA.
Nice. A big sale, as reported by SC Daily, a single signed Walter Johnson American League Baseball with the original box sold for over $315,000 early Sunday as a part of Leland's spring catalog auction. The price is the most ever paid for a ball signed by Johnson, who died in 1946 at the age of 59.
Yeah, cut autos of him are hard to come by. And the fact that that person had the original box still,
yes,
that's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Walter Johnson is the only member of the inaugural class of the Hall of Fame of who I don't own a game used memorabilia card.
What was his nickname? Do you know?
The Big Train.
Very good.
And I keep it on the watch list, but it's probably not going to happen. The only game used card to ever come out for Walter Johnson was game used baseball card by Panini in National Treasures Baseball. And they typically, when they do pop up, I think there's only five, and they usually go for $3,000
to $3,500. Really? Nice. Wow. That's awesome.
Anyway, on to things. Well, let's talk PSA collectible magazine covers. Here's a preview of the new issue with editor-in-chief and publisher Jack Archer.
It's Grail Mary season at PSA Magazine this month with a trio of GOAT wide receivers fronting our May issue. Randy Moss, Jerry Rice, and Larry Fitzgerald. Each cover will be evenly and randomly allocated to Collectors Club members, with the lucky 84 receiving a Randy Moss variant in gold form. Inside, Larry Fitzgerald kicks things off with Best Hands in the Hobby, an exclusive interview that covers what it's like to super collect yourself. Next up, Top Set Maverick, a collector Q&A with the wild stat line. Over 5,100 PSA-graded Dirk Nowitzki cards, including 127 one-of-ones. Super Freak rampages through Randy Moss's best cards, Rare Air skies above the rest with Michael Jordan and Nike, and Pokemon crashes game night and a wild card appears. Next, PSA autograph sales rep and Jerry Rice fanatic Michael Diaz speeds into Fast Five, Kaboom Kabust covers market highs and lows, and a Funko Pop quick hitter closes things out. That's it for this issue, and in case you missed it, the latest upgrade to the PSA app debuts an interactive new grade reveal experience. Don't wait to download. I'm Jack Archer for PSA. Thank you for watching.
This week, Upper Deck unveiled its evolution for authentic digital collectibles. Now, before you roll your eyes, Upper Deck has put a creative spin on things, furthering the bridge between digital and physical. Once an authentic digital collectible is purchased on Evolution, it can remain on the platform and be traded for other authentic digital collectibles. Alternatively, it can be transferred to EPAC and traded for physical items like trading cards, grander coins, and memorabilia in a safe and secure peer-to-peer platform, making this the first time in the hobby that digital collectible items can be traded for physical items and vice versa.
Very cool. That is...
That's
definitely
nice.
Cool. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, here's a sweet deal from Breckitt Grading Services for this week only. Take advantage of free ground shipping on standard and priority card grading orders.
Signatures for Soldiers has once again been named the official charity partner for this year's National Sports Collectors Convention in Chicago. Pristine Auction will be hosting a month-long auction in July, with the money going directly to SFS to help the homeless and disabled veterans. Additionally, the organization, which is a fully licensed 501c3, is currently accepting donations for items to include in the auction. Particular items of interest are star player autograph cards and autograph memorabilia. If you'd like to donate items, please contact Signatures for Soldiers on Twitter at SIGS, the number 4, Soldiers.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.